Now, my experience with a strong black woman was after a few years at a certain prison, they were bringing in a new warden, and she was black. So all these, I never thought about it till now, that all these stereotypes kicked in. People started saying, oh, she's pretty much like Mandy, like, she's gonna be strict as hell, she's gonna change a whole bunch of things, trying to kiss ass to the white man, this and that, and this and that. And so everybody had a perception about her, you know, the way she was gonna be when she came in. And, but it was actually total opposite. She came in and things got a lot easier. Rules got a little bit easier. She did a lot for the inmates that were in there. She even brought in, who remembers the boxer? From Pensacola? Roy Jones. She would bring in Roy Jones with his basketball team. He had a basketball team that he used to play basketball with. So they used to come and play basketball with our team in the prison. So she even introduced me to him personally. And one time, a congressman was going to come and visit the prison, and she asked me to perform for her because she's black and white. So to me, meeting that lady, she was very strong, professional, and it was a black woman that I looked up to. She wasn't famous, she wasn't a Nicki Minaj, or Beyonce, or anybody like that. But she was my image of a strong black
woman. I'm very honored to learn about it because even though I am from Mexican descent, my family's been here since the 1800s. I think the border crossed us way back in the day. So, and I was telling some of the students here that our family never celebrated this. And I don't think we even knew about it. My mom never told us about it. We would see it on TV and stuff like that, but we never knew what it was, what it meant. So to me, it's an honor to learn about it because it's part of our ancestors.